Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back. Today, we're going to talk about how to preserve and protect a signature slash autograph on your guitar or your pick guard. Now, this is honestly a super popular question. Like, a lot of you have asked me how to do this. So, let's set the stage a little, shall we? You know, you go to a rock concert and you happen to bring your guitar along because you're weird. And lo and behold, after the concert, you're walking around and you see your favorite musician of all time, Meg White, and you walk up to her and tell her, "Wow, I really admire your talent and your skill. Would you give me your autograph?" And for some reason, instead of signing your boob, she signs your instrument. Well, what do you do to preserve that? So unfortunately, Sharpie fades. You thought to bring a guitar, but not a paint pen, did you? Anyway, this stuff isn't super UV resistant, but that doesn't mean that we can't protect it. We want to make sure that it's not just going to rub off. I also assume that you didn't have the foresight to sand the surface to allow for better adhesion. So let's go ahead and throw a couple signatures on here. Great drummer. That's just a blob. That's special right there. All right, and you may have noticed I'm not writing Meg White on any of my stuff. Sorry, she's not my favorite drummer of all time. Anyway, famous person. All right, how do we keep these? What we want to do here is clear coat over these signatures so that they're stuck under a layer of something that protects them. The problem here is pick guards, generally shiny, and plastic. Very difficult for anything to stick to that. Generally, your guitar will also be rather glossy. A very smooth surface like that, again, an issue for things to stick to. So the first thing that we need to do is go ahead and abrade these with something. I'm gonna use a maroon piece of Scotch-Brite. Now, if I don't say this, 10 of you are gonna ask me this question. Yes, you can use sandpaper. I recommend 600 grit. I just prefer the Scotch-Brite. Guaranteed somebody's still gonna ask me that question. But anyway, the maroon stuff works well. Gray is also entirely adequate. The maroon is a little bit more abrasive than the gray, and it's what I happen to have right next to me. Won't be a problem either way. They're both fine for this kind of thing. 600 grit paper, if you want to use sandpaper instead, go for that. And if you don't have 600, 400 will do just fine. 800 will also work. Now, unfortunately, we can't just go and sand the whole surface like we normally would here. Because that'll obviously mess up the signatures. But at the same time, we want to have as much of the surface abraded as we can because that's gonna help us get something to stick to it. So what you're gonna do is just sand real close to it. Get real nice and close and then sand the entire rest of the surface. And the clear coat that we put on there is gonna bridge those areas. And the idea is it's going to basically, just coat over that area and its own strength is going to hold it together, notwithstanding that it won't bind to that area quite the way that it will to everything else. So sand everything other than that, because if you try and paint over too much glossy area, you're going to end up with your paint just peeling off after. Now the choice of clear coat here is up to you, and it depends a little bit on what your guitar is already coated with. If you've got a guitar that's entirely done in lacquer, like this one, technically you don't need to sand it. I recommend you do anyway, just in case. Better safe than sorry. But technically, if you've got it done in nitrocellulose lacquer and you are recoating with nitrocellulose lacquer, it's going to melt into itself, because lacquer never cures, so you don't technically need to sand, it will bond. It's hard to tell for sure without messing with it a little bit if it actually is nitrocellulose lacquer, unless you already know that. And also, giving it a nice little scuff and coating over it isn't gonna hurt anything, even if it is lacquer. So why don't you just go ahead and do that. Real close here, real nice and close. Just like that. Okay. Next step is to clean these. So we can't be painting right over the dust that we've just sanded off of here. That would not be good. So we need to clean these. Go ahead and get your wax and grease remover and clean right up to the edge where you sanded. Be very careful if you're going to clean over the marker. If it's been there for a while, fine. If not, very gently over top of that. Wax and grease remover should not remove Sharpie. If it does, well, you know what? Maybe just don't do that. Just wipe over top of it. But anyway, wax and grease remover should not remove your Sharpie. So if you go over it gently, it shouldn't be a problem. If you scrub at it, it's going to be a problem. Don't create a problem. Same deal on the plastic. You have to be even a little bit more careful if you're doing this on a pick guard, because Sharpie, just like paint, doesn't love sticking to plastic. It may be acetone based. It is acetone based, spoiler alert, but that doesn't mean that it's going to go ahead and melt right into the plastic every time. It depends on what kind of plastic it is. So be careful. Don't scrub it. If there's an easy separation on your guitar so that you can just do like the face that the signature is on, go ahead and do that. If not, you may have to coat the whole thing. Check out my videos on how to paint your guitar if you want to see how to disassemble it and all that stuff. Anyway, we are almost there. We've abraded it, we've cleaned it. You are this close, one step away from having Meg White's signature permanently on your instrument. Congratulations. Last step is clear coat. This is where you're gonna have to make some decisions. Do you wanna just use hardware store clear coat? Yeah, you can probably get away with that. Might not be the greatest idea, but it's possible. If you want awesome UV protection for it and the hardest finish possible, you're gonna wanna catalyze polyurethane most likely. You can get that in a mixable format to spray through a gun if you've got it, or you can use the 2K Spray Max spray cans. If you want to see how to use those, check out my video on how to get a professional looking coat of clear coat, professional looking clear coat with spray cans. That's what it is. And if you want to pick one of those up, check out the Amazon link in the description. It's in there. I'm going to be using Bell & Stringed Instrument Lacquer, also available in the description. Same link, Amazon. It's all in there. This comes in quarts, gallons, and spray cans if you want them. I'm going to do it with a spray can because I assume that's what you're doing. This stuff is great. I love it. It's my favorite spray can lacquer. And it's especially good in a situation where you have a guitar that's been painted with lacquer, which is what I did with this one, notwithstanding that was pre-catalyzed. There's a bunch of polish in the pickup cavity. Just ignore that. That won't be the case on your guitar. Now, every time somebody picks up a can of lacquer to coat something, they seem to feel like they need to do 10, 15, 380 coats of paint. So I want you to remember, pick guards typically don't need clear coat. So don't, you just put enough on to protect the thing. And your guitar, presumably, was already painted. So you don't need 10 coats of lacquer. You just need enough to seal it in there. One, maybe two. Now this stuff, like most aerosol paints, is about as deadly as Meg White's killer drum solos. No, seriously, this will kill you. So wear a mask, and I don't mean a dust mask, get a respirator. Like, you're gonna be painting something, particularly in this situation where you've got somebody signing your stuff, it's worth it to invest the $40 or whatever it is, Canadian, in a respirator, all right? You don't need to suit up in a hazmat suit, but protect your lungs. This stuff will not be good for them. And yeah, you guessed it. Respirators available, same link, description. If you're using a hardware store aerosol or even this lacquer, you can probably get away with these half masks. Not really an issue, especially if you're not doing this very frequently. If you're spraying frequently or if you're using that catalyzed clear coat, that stuff's got a lot of isocyanates in it. I really recommend the full face mask and gloves and pretty much anything else you can do to protect yourself from this stuff. The catalyzed clear is brutal for you. It's very toxic, very unhealthy. They all are, but that stuff's the worst. Anyway, I'm in a massive, well-ventilated room right now. I'm spraying a uncatalyzed lacquer. So I'm gonna go ahead, put my mask on, throw a coat on these guys. And that's how you protect and preserve a signature. An autograph? Signature. I just wrote some stuff. Anyway, let's spray.
So two additional items that I should mention here very quickly. The first is when you're painting on plastic like I do on the pickguard here, you should toss a quick coat of adhesion promoter on there first to be on the safe side and ensure that whatever you're putting on there is going to stick a little better Because we're not in a position to use a plastic compatible primer here, we have to move straight to a clear coat. The second item here I did mention in text earlier, and that is that you may want to consider using an acrylic clear coat as a medium. And what I mean by that is that you put it down before you move on to your solvent-based clears because it is less likely to create any sort of bleeding issues. Sometimes these lacquers and catalyzed polyurethanes, the chemicals in them can create bleeding in the Sharpie or in any type of marker. So you put the acrylic down first to avoid that problem and act as a barrier. Now you'll notice that on the guitar itself, that wasn't an issue. This signature came out quite clear despite having only been signed a few minutes ago. But on the pick guard, you can see a little bit of bleeding there. That signature was a little bit of a blob before, but with this close up, you can tell it's kind of starting to spread just a little bit. Now it doesn't get worse than that, but had we used an acrylic clear coat initially, we would have been able to avoid that problem because the solvents from the clear wouldn't have had the opportunity to affect the signature.
And there we go, guys. Question answered. That is how you preserve and protect a signature slash autograph on your guitar or your pick guard. Now I gotta go sand all this crap off. Anyway, wait for it to dry first. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, please feel free to give it a thumbs up. I would appreciate it. Remember to subscribe if you haven't already so you can check out all the other projects we're doing. And yeah, stick around, stay tuned. We got stuff coming up. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one. Oh, I feel like I blasted through that ending. It smells like lacquer in here.